One of the attractions of flying in and around St. Petersburg are the white nights. Darkness falls around midnight in the summer and the sun sleeps for just 3 hours. And while the pilots sleep, planning for the next race, the next set of tasks is already underway. FAI meteorologist Martin Harris scans the satellites and watches the weather.
The weather limitations for flying an airship are very crucial. Firstly, you need to inflate it, and you can't inflate it if it's flapping around like the spinnaker on a sailing yacht. You very often have a line of thunderstorms on the eastern side of the city in a great arc, so you've got to keep away from that. So you do have to do it early morning and late evening when it's not too windy. You need to be a very perceptive pilot to notice the changes in the sky when you're flying. It's quite a busy time flying any aircraft, and most pilots are attuned to major changes. To be an absolute award-winning pilot, a championship-winning pilot, you need to be quick to see the diagnostic indicators of a change in the weather before the other competitors do. Sometimes it's a tree spread out downwind, shaking its leaves, showing that there's a surface wind in a local area. Sometimes it's bonfire smoke. Sometimes it's just a little wisp of cloud. So pilots who are alert to these minor but very significant changes. Competition flying in airships is not tiddlywinks or tennis, it's high technology backed with high-tech meteorology.
Wind speed from 2 to 3 meters per second, 4-6 knots.
The Russian sun hasn't always been shining down on the championship. Wind and rain has put paid to too many flights. But on the last morning, the conditions are near perfect. The Hot Air Airship Championship is go. Task this morning are touch and go. Pilots have to land one wheel and take off again. Then there's more target practice. And to finish off, a champagne pickup.
Flying an airship is more like steering a yacht. So you're actually using the wind to tack and guide you through the air. And that's exactly what an airship does. You're actually guiding it through the air because you can't really go so hard like an aircraft and cut through it. So you must allow for the fact that the wind will help you or it may hinder you. So it's quite a unique experience and very, very skilled. Here today, there's some quite inexperienced and new pilots. And then there are pilots who have been doing it for quite a number of years who have accrued quite a few hundred hours on these machines. And they've done that through a combination of commercial flying and also hobby flying. And I'm here, yes, to support the Italian pilot as part of the Italian team. And really, it's for us, it's a venture out of Europe into something new. I mean, it's our first time competing. So it's for all of us a really new experience. It's something quite exceptional.
Oh, it's getting tougher, much tougher. And I would say that's definitely to do with that the equipment is getting better. If you go back 15 years ago, when you're starting then, you have like version 4 and version 1 airship competing at the same time. That's not happening anymore. I mean, now we have very high tech, very engineered, nice airships, which means that, a lot of pilots is doing a lot, much better results. So I think we need to think about, even coming up with more tasks to try to separate, because otherwise it'll be, one pilot has 3,021, the other one has 3,042. The difference is so small that then it starts to go into luck, and we don't like that. So we need to think about, what can the new versions of the airship, what they can do that could be, showing the skill of the pilots.
But Oscar's having bad luck. His engine fan has sucked up the target. No world title for him.
I did get a small damage on the belt when I made the check. So the question was, should I go on? What is the risk that the belt breaks and then I won't have any force at all? But because my airship has a separate engine from the pressure, it's much more safe, even if the main engine stops. So I said, okay, let's go. But I can't go more than maybe 40% of the power because then the belt will break. So I continued to pick up the champagne bottle, about 25-30% power. And then I went down to the next target. using 30% power, and I just made it down to the next target, so I will have some score there. Oh, wonderful morning. This is what Airship is all about, you know, it's cruising like whales.
Jacques-Antoine Bénard is way, way out in front with a score of 5,585. He's 400 points clear. The FAI's Jean-Claude Weber knows a champion when he sees one.
We do have a true world champion because he's an old world champion and who has maintained his qualities and skills during the last some years. So I think he's a worthy world champion. I think he has a lot of experience. He's very patient. He's a very, very skillful pilot, and that makes a big difference.
So the race is on for the rest. The only woman competing is Ludmila Ushakova of Russia. Her Airship is the newest, the latest model here. But what she would have given for more competition practice, more time in the air. Poland's Bamberski Wojciech was an early leader, but his challenge is fading. The German ship piloted by Kerner Eckhart is looking good, and it's between him and Russia's Nikolai Galkin for the runners-up spot. In the end, it's Galkin. He scores 5,160 to Eckhart's 5,125.
The competition has been very good, very well organized. It's a pity the weather wasn't a bit better, but I'm very pleased and proud to be in second place.
We're honored to welcome you here at the Peter and Paul's Fortress for the closing ceremony of the 8th FAI World Hot Air Airship Championship 2008.
I'm happy. I'm thrilled to have won this for the third time. No one's ever done this before. This is a first for airships.
So the world champion reigns. The FAI plans for bigger and better next time around. And St. Petersburg celebrates with the White Knights of Hot Air Airships.